Solutions. Level 1. One of the main goals in an introductory level course is to solve or find solutions of differential equations. In this video, we will explore the concept of a solution of an ordinary differential equation. Let's first start with the following definition. Any function defined on an interval I and possessing at least n derivatives that are continuous on I, which when substituted into an nth order ordinary differential equation, also known as an ODE, reduces the equation to an identity, is said to be a solution of the equation on the interval I. In other words, a solution of an nth order ordinary differential equation is a function that possesses at least n derivatives and for which the equation equals zero for all x and I. If this is the case, we say that the function satisfies the differential equation on I. In these videos, we shall also assume that a solution is a real-valued function, as opposed to an imaginary or complex function. It might be confusing to use phi to represent the solution of an ODE at a given interval. So we will also use y as a function of x to denote a solution of an ODE at a given interval. It is important to notice right off the bat that a solution to a differential equation is a function, unlike the solution to an algebraic equation, which is usually a number or a set of numbers. This makes differential equations much more interesting and often more challenging to understand than algebraic equations. It is very important to associate a solution of an ordinary differential equation with an interval. The interval I is known as the interval of definition. It is also referred to as the interval of existence, the interval of validity, or the domain of the solution. This interval can be an open interval, a closed interval, an infinite interval, or all real numbers. For example, say that we are asked to verify if the following function, y equals 1/16 times x to the power of 4, is a solution to the given differential equation, y prime equals x times y raised to the power of 1/2, on the interval negative infinity to positive infinity. In other words, all real numbers. One way of verifying that the given function is a solution is to check, after substituting, whether each side of the equation is the same for every value of x in the interval. Let's first find the derivative of the function. Taking the derivative of 1/16 times x raised to the power of 4, we obtain 1/4 times x raised to the power of 3. You need to be comfortable taking derivatives. If you need a refresher, you can always go back and check the derivative videos under Calculus 1. Alright, having found the derivative, let's proceed to substitute the function y in its derivative. Always use parentheses when carrying out a substitution. It will help reduce any errors associated with negative signs. Carrying out the substitution and reducing the expression, we obtain the following. Notice that we reduce the equation into an identity. Each side of the equation is the same for every real number x in the interval. This means that the function is indeed a solution to the differential equation at the given interval, in this case, all real numbers. At times, the interval might not be all real numbers, like in the following example. Show that the following function, y equals x raised to the power of negative 3/2, is a solution to the differential equation 4x squared times y double prime plus 12x times y prime plus 3y equals 0, for x is greater than 0. Alright, looking at the ODE, we see that we are going to need the first and second derivative of the function. The first derivative is equal to the following expression, and the second derivative is equal to the following. It is just a matter of applying the power rule from Calculus 1, or differential calculus. Next, we go ahead and substitute the function and its derivatives into the ODE, as follows. Making sure we use parentheses when carrying out the substitution. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and simplify the expressions. Doing that, we obtain the following. Notice that we can simplify the left-hand side of the equation by collecting like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following. 0 is equal to 0. Notice that the left-hand side is equal to the right-hand side of the equation. Hence, the function is a solution of the differential equation. We are not done yet. We need to assign an interval for this solution. Notice that the interval was already given to us. In this case, the interval is from 0 exclusive to positive infinity, or all the values of x that are greater than 0. Why is this function a solution to the ODE in this interval only? Recall that we can rewrite the solution to this ODE as follows. 1 over the square root of x cubed. In this form, it is clear that we need to avoid x equals 0 because division by 0 is undefined. We also have a radical function, specifically a square root function. Recall that we are only interested in real values. So if our differential equation only contains real numbers, then we don't want solutions that yield imaginary or complex numbers. So in an effort to avoid imaginary or complex numbers, we will also need to avoid negative values of x. As a result, our domain is restricted to only positive values that are greater than 0. Hence the interval of definition. This is why it is important to define an interval when finding a solution to a differential equation. Even though a function may symbolically satisfy a differential equation, because of certain restrictions brought about by the solution, we cannot use all the values of the independent variable and hence must make a restriction on the independent variable. This will be the case with many solutions to differential equations. Notice that each differential equation possesses the constant solution y equals 0 in the interval negative infinity to positive infinity, or all real numbers. If we were to substitute this function and its derivatives into the ODE, we would technically satisfy the ODE, a solution of a differential equation that is identically 0 on an interval I is said to be a trivial solution. For the most part, we will want to find non-trivial solutions of ODEs. With this in mind, we will shift gears and talk about solution curves. The graph of a solution of an ODE is called a solution curve. Since the solution is a differentiable function, it is continuous on its interval I of definition. With that said, there may be a difference between the graph of the function and the graph of the solution. In other words, the domain of the function is not always the same as the interval I of definition or domain of the solution. Let's illustrate this with the following example. Verify that the function y equals 1 over x is a solution to the differential equation x times y prime plus y equals 0. Alright, notice that this ODE is a first order linear ODE, so we need to substitute the function and the first derivative into the ODE. Let's first find the derivative of the function. Applying the power rule, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and substitute the function and its derivative into the equation, as follows. Then we go ahead and simplify the expressions. Then we collect like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. 0 is equal to 0. So we have verified that this function is indeed a solution to the ODE. Now we need to assign an appropriate interval of definition. To figure out the interval of definition, let's take a look at the graph of y equals 1 over x. Notice that the domain of this function is a set of all real numbers x except 0. The rational function is discontinuous at x equals 0. It essentially has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. Because of this discontinuity, the function is not differentiable at x equals 0. Recall that a solution to a differential equation has to be differentiable at the given interval, as well as satisfying the differential equation. If we look at this function as a solution to the differential equation, we need to assign an interval of definition. This interval can be anywhere except at x equals 0. It can be the interval negative 2 to negative 1, or the interval 3 to 4, or the interval from negative infinity to 0 exclusive, or the interval from 0 exclusive to positive infinity. In all these intervals, the function is differentiable and produces real numbers, as opposed to complex or imaginary numbers. For the most part, we want the interval of definition to be as large as possible. So we want I to be either negative infinity to 0 exclusive or 0 exclusive to positive infinity. In this example, it really does not matter which interval we choose, as long as the solution is differentiable in the given interval and yields real numbers. In a much later video, we will come across specific problems that require us to choose one interval over the other. For now, either interval are acceptable answers. Alright, in our next video, we will practice verifying solutions to differential equations and determining appropriate intervals of definition.